So the relationship between Celsius and Fahrenheit, we could derive just now. What is that relation? C minus 0 by 100, F minus 32 by 180. So 0, 0 cancel, 5, next 9. Then what happens? C by 5, F minus 32 by 9. This is the relation. In the exam, you will get the question. Explain about the Celsius and Fahrenheit temperature and what is the relation between the Celsius and Fahrenheit. Then you have to do, you have to derive the, this equation, you have to write about this Celsius and you have to write about the Fahrenheit. What is the least value, what is the maximum value, what is the minimum value. Here also, what is the maximum value, what is the minimum value. Already is about C, 0, this starting point, then ending point is starting point, then ending point is 100. Next, Fahrenheit I said already, 32 is the starting point, 212 is the ending point. Then difference how much will be there, 180 will be there. Then we have taken here, how much difference will be there, 100. Then we got the relation, this is. Okay, based on this, you will get one question that I am going to take one example. Okay, convert 30 degrees centigrade. I'm going to take one problem, small problem I'm taking. Okay, convert 30 degree centigrade into Fahrenheit. So what is given here? Convert 30 degree centigrade. How much is given? C is equal to, as given, 30 degree centigrade. What is asking? How much in the Fahrenheit is asking? So what we can do simply, C 30 degrees centigrade by how much is there? 5. Write the formula first. What is the formula? C by 5 is equal to F minus 32 by 9. Then what happened? C is equal to how much is there? 30 is there. Next, by how much is there? 5. F minus 32 by 9. Okay, 5, 6. 5, 5 is a 25. 5, 6 is a 30. Then what happened? 6 into 6 is equal to F minus 32 by, what is that? 9. Again, 6 into 9. F minus 32. So, 6 into 9, how much we will get? Definitely, you will get the 54. 54, again F minus 32. Then what happened? 54 plus 32 is equal to F. 54 plus 32, how much? This is 6 and this is 86. How much you are getting total? 86 Fahrenheit. What is your temperature now? 86. So if one measurement is given, we can convert into another measurement. Okay, here what I have given, what in the problem itself, what is given here? Simply is given the 30 degree centigrade. It is converted into Fahrenheit. Okay, sometime you may get the problem. Suppose you may give in the Fahrenheit, then you have to convert into centigrade. Okay, for that we will take the another problem. Convert 212 Fahrenheit in Celsius. Celsius. Again, same relation we have to use, C by 5, F minus 32 by 9. Okay, now which value is given? Now he has given the F is equal to. F is equal to how much is given? 212. Then simply substitute. Then how much you will get? Simply if you substitute C by 5, next to 212 minus 32 by 9. Then what happened? C by C is equal to 212 minus 32 into 9 into 5. Simply if you calculate, you will get automatically 100 degree centigrade. If you calculate this one, if you, okay, like that we can solve the problems. So based on this principle. Okay, next, another relation will be there. So what is the relationship between Celsius, comma, Fahrenheit and Kelvin? Already I said about what you can add, same thing, C by 100, F minus 32 by 180, next K minus 273 by 100, 0 0 cancel, 0 0 cancel, then again C by 10, F minus 32 by 18, Okay. Till now we discuss about, previously we discuss about the degree Celsius and Fahrenheit. Okay, sometime they may ask, convert the Fahrenheit into Kelvin. Okay, some you may get among these two relations also, or among those two, any two relations, any two combinations you may get. So sometime they are given like this, C by 5 is equal to K minus 273 by 5. Then they are given 40 degrees centigrade. Then what we can do simply? 40 degree centigrade. Then convert into Kelvin. What we can do simply? C is equal to how much is there? 40 by 5. K minus 273 by 5. 5, 5 gets cancelled. See, what we can do simply? You can add. So what we can say? 40 plus 273 is equal to Kelvin. So if he ask any temperature is given another 2 Celsius also Fahrenheit, what you have to do? If you convert means convert into Kelvin means, what we can do simply, you can add the 273, then we can get your answer, then we can say that is the Kelvin temperature. So among this you will get any one question in your IP exam. This is very, very easy. Remember that last relation.